Hi my dear students, welcome back to Gurudev online classes. So in the last class of 8 maths, we were discussing the top 10 squares and square roots, right? So in the last previous classes, we had learned about the properties of the squares and square numbers, and also we had solved the exercise 5.1, right? So today in this class, we are going to discuss some more concept about this square number. Okay, so first find the square of a number. Okay. So you already know how to find the square of a number. See, if 2 is a number, then what is its square? 2 square, that is 4, right? So then if 9 is a number, what is its square? 9 square, that is 81, right? So 11, if 11 is a number, then how you can find the square of the 11? 11 square, that is 11 into 11, 121, right? So you can find the numbers which are smaller. But how can you find the numbers which are 23? Okay, the square of 23. So 23 square. How you can find? It is 23 into 23. It becomes very large number to multiply and to get answer. So we have a easier method to find the square of the larger numbers. Yes, today we are going to discuss about that method. See, 23. Find the square of 23. So how can you find the square of 23? I said you 23 square, that is 23 into 23. It is heavy to multiply. So what we can do, the simplest way, 23 can be written as 20 plus 3, right? 23 can be written as 20 plus 3, right? So I have expressed 23 as 20 plus 3. So we want 23 square. Right. So what we can do here? 20 plus 3 square. Right. So 23 square. 23 can be written as 20 plus 3 whole square. So 20 plus 3 whole square. This is in the form of a plus b whole square. Right. This 20 plus 3 whole square is in the form of a plus b whole square. Then what is this a plus b whole square? A square plus 2ab plus b square, right? This is an identity. A plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2a. So we can write 20 plus 3 whole square as, how you can write 20 plus 3 whole square? We can write in the form of this identity. That is a square means 20 square plus 2 into a, that is 20, b, that is 3 here, right? Plus b square, that is 3 square. Clear? I am applying this 20 plus 3 through this identity. Right. So now 20 square, that is 2 2's are 4, 2 zeros. Right. So this is a 20 square, 400. Plus 2 2's are 4, 4 3's are 12, 120. Plus 3 3's are 9. Right. So 400 plus 120 plus 9. How much you get? 529. Right. So in the simple, easy way, we can find the square of 23. Clear? See, once again I will repeat. To find the square of a larger numbers, there is a trick or there is an easy method. So what is an easy method? I will express this 23 as 20 plus 3. Right? So if you get 0 here in the units place, we will easily get the answers. Right? So to get a 0, I will write this 23 as 20 plus 3. So this is the form of a plus b whole square. So we want 23 whole square, right? Square of 23, that is 23 square, which is equal to 20 plus 3 whole square. So this is in the form of identity, that is a plus b whole square. So a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Just I will apply the a and b terms here. So 20 square plus 2 into 20 into 3 plus 3 square, right? So now 20 square, you already know 20 square, how you can get? 2 2's are 4, so 1 0 is there. So when you do square, you will get 2 zeros, right? So 400 plus 2 into 2 into 3. Okay, 2 2's are 4, 4 3's are 12. So 120 plus 3 3's are 9. So when you add 400 plus 120 plus 9, you will get 529, right? So in an easy way, you will get the square of a larger number. So for example, one more number. Let's take 39. 39. So we want to find the square of 39, that is 39 square. So we can multiply 39. becomes a heavy metal. So we cannot multiply that large numbers. So what we can do? We can express 39 as 30 plus 9, right? 30 plus 9 whole square. So if you get here 0, you will easily get the answer. So to get 0 here, I will write this 39 as 30 plus 9, right? So this is again in the form of a plus b whole square. So what is a plus b whole square? A square. That is 30 square plus 2ab. That is 2 into 30 into 9 plus b square. That is 9 square. Clear? Yes. A plus b whole square can be written as a square plus 2ab plus b square. Right? So next, 30 square. 3 threes are 9. So 1 0 is there. In the square, you get 2 zeros, right? 900. Plus 2 threes are 6. 6 nines are 54. Okay, 540. Plus 9 nines are 81. So when you add this, how much you get? 1521. Right? So in an easy way, we can find the value of our 39 square or square of 39. Clear? So one more example. Let's take 42. So 42, how you can do that? So now one more example. Find the square of 42. Okay. So that is 42 square. So how you can express 42? 42 can be expressed as 40 plus 2. Right? Whole square. So this is again in the form of a plus b whole square. Right? So what is a plus b whole square? A square plus 2ab plus b square. So a square. In the place of a, 40 is there. So 40 square plus 2 into in the place of a 40. Again in the place of b 2 plus b square. So in the place of b 2 is there 2 square. Clear? So now 4 40 square. 4 4s are 16. So 2 zeros plus 4 2s are 8. 8 2s are 16. 16. That is 160. Plus 2 2s are 4. Clear? So what is 1600 plus 160 plus 4? How much you get? The sum of 1600 plus 160 plus 4. How much you get? 1764. Right? How much you get when you add 1600 plus 160 plus 4? 1764. Right? So 1764 is the square of the number 42. You can check by doing 42 into 42, you will get the same answer, right? So in an easy way, without multiplying, we can easily find the square of our numbers, right? So in this way, by expressing this number in the form of 30 plus 9, so you got this in an easy way. So you can find the square of any number without multiplying it in an easy way by using the identity. Clear? So in this way, we have to solve this larger numbers. We have to find the square of the larger numbers. Clear? So let's move on to the next topic. We had seen in the last that how to find the square of a larger numbers like 23, 39, 42, right? So we also have a trick to find the numbers which are ending, to find the square of the numbers which are ending with the number 5 or which have in its units place the digit 5, like 25, 75, 125. We can find the square of 25, 75 and 125 in a easy way. So how you can find this? See, observe here, so there are some examples. 25 square, it is 625, right? When you do 25 into 25, you get 625. So there is an easy method to find the square of 25. How? Here, 2 into 3 hundreds plus 25. Okay, if you do, you will get the 625. So here 75 square, the answer is 5625. Okay, when you multiply 75 into 75, you will get 5625. The easy method to find the square of 75 without multiplying them is 7 into 8 into hundreds plus 25. Okay, so for 125, to find the square of 125 without multiplying, what is the trick? 12 into 13, hundreds plus 25. Okay, 12 into 13, hundreds plus 25. So these are the tricks to find the squares of our numbers which are ending with the digit 5. Okay, so these are the tricks. So how we got this trick? Yes. So here is an explanation how you got this trick to find the anything, but its unit place should be 5. This A may be any number, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, 12, 13, 23, 43, anything. If a number has 5 in its unit place, then we can find the square of that number in this way. So, see, A 5 whole square, that is, let us take 25 whole square. Let us take this A 5 whole square has, in the place of A 2 is there, okay, 25 whole square. It can be written as 20 plus 5, right? I had said you in the last that we can express a number in the form of tens, that is 20 plus 5 whole square. We can write this. We can write 25 as 20 plus A whole square. This 20, how you got? 10 into 2 plus 5 whole square. Right. So, A 5 whole square can be expressed as 10 into A plus 5 whole square. Right. So, A 5 whole square can be expressed as in this form. That is, 10 into 2 means 10 into A. So, 10 into A plus 5 whole square. So, we can express this here in the form of 10 into A plus 5 square. So, this is in the form of A plus B whole square. Right. So, A plus B whole square. How you can write? A square plus 2AB plus B square. Clear? So, A square, that is 10A whole square plus 2 into 10A into B, that is 5, plus B square, that is 5 square. So, 10A whole square, that is 100 A square, right, plus 100A. 2 into 10, 2 tens are 20, 20 into 500, so 100A plus 5 is 25. Clear? So, now 100 A square and here 100 A. So, we can take 100 A as common from these two. Yes, we can take 100 A as a common from these two. So, what is the remaining here? A plus 1. Right? So, if you take 100 A as a common, here the remaining is A, here plus 1. See, 100 A into A, again 100 A square plus 100 A into 1, 100 A. Right? So, we can take 100 A as a common. So, you got here A plus 1 plus 25 as it is. So, here this 100 A into A plus 1 can be written as A into A plus 1 into 100. Right? Just I have taken 100 and I have shifted here. First A into A plus 1 into 100 plus 25 as it is. So, what we can write this as? A into A plus 1, 100 plus 25. Right? So, this is same as this. So, 2 into 3, 100 plus 25. Okay. A means here, let's take this example. Okay. So, A means 2, right? So, A means in the 25, this is A. 2 is A. So, 2 into 2 plus 1 is 3. So, 2 into 3, 100 plus 25. See? 2 into 3, 100 plus 25. If you do this, how much you get? 2 into 3, 6. 6 into 100, 600 plus 25, 625. Clear? So, by using this, that is A5 whole square is equal to A into A plus 1, 100 plus 25. Okay? So, A into A plus 1. See, this is A. So, 2 into 2 plus 1, that is 3. 2 into 3, 100 plus 25. Right? So, this 75 square, A is 7. So, 7 into 7 plus 1, that is 8. 7 into 8, 100 plus 25. 7 into 8 is 56, right? 56 into 100, 5600. 5600 plus 25, 5625. Clear? So, this 125 square. So, in 125, this whole term is A. So, 12 is a A. So, 12 into 12 plus 1, 13. So, 12 into 13, 100 plus 25. 12 into 13 into 100. 12 into 13, how much you get? 156. Right, into 100, how much you get? 12 into 13 is 156 into 100 plus 25. Okay, so 156 into 100 is 15,600 plus 25. So, what is 15,600 plus 25? 15625. Right, see, 15625. Clear? So, in this way, by using this formula, we can easily find the square of a numbers whose units digit ends with or whose units digit has 5. Okay, or which ends with the digit 5. Okay, by applying this, A5 whole square is A into A plus 1, 100 plus 25. We can easily find the numbers. behind the 5, the term, whole term is taken as A. So A into A plus 1 into 100 plus 25. Clear? So this is one of the method to find the square of a numbers ending with the digit 5. Clear? So this is about this method. So next, now the next topic is Pythagorean triplets. So you already know about the Pythagoras theorem, right? So let's take a right angle. Okay, let's take a right angle. So in this right angle, A is the height, right? So A is the height, B is the base, right? So and C is the hypotenuse. C is the hypotenuse, which is the largest length. Okay, B is the base and A is the height. So we can express this in the form of A square plus B square is equal to C square. This is a Pythagoras triplet formula. Okay, this is a Pythagoras theorem. A square plus B square is equal to C square. The sum of squares of base and height is equal to the square of hypotenuse. Okay, here A, B, C are the Pythagoras triplets. Okay, what are these Pythagoras triplets? See, for example, 3, 4, 5 forms a Pythagoras triplet. Is it forms Pythagoras triplet or not? Let's check. See, 3 square plus B square. See, A square plus B square plus is equal to C square. We shall apply for 3, 4, 5. So, 3 square plus 4 square is equal to 5 square. Okay, in the place of A, 3. In the place of B, 4. In the place of C, 5. It means, in the place of A, 3 is there. In the place of B, 4 is there. In the place of C, 5 is there. So now, A square plus B square plus C square. That is 3 square plus 4 square is equal to 5 square. So 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16 is equal to 5 square is 25. See, 9 plus 16, 25, which is equal to 25. Right? So this numbers forms a Pythagoras triplet. Okay, if LHS becomes equal to RHS, we can say this numbers forms a Pythagoras triplet. Let's see some of the other examples. 6, 8, 10. We shall take the Pythagorean triplet has 6, 8, 10. Is this number 6, 8, 10 on the Pythagorean triplets? Let's see. Okay, A square plus B square plus C square. That is 6 square plus A square is equal to 10 square. So 6, 6 are 36. Right. 8, 8 are 64, which is equal to 10 square. That is 100. Right. See, 36 plus 64, 100, right, is equal to 100. LHS is equal to RHS. So what we can say? This number 6, 8, 10 forms a Pythagorean triplet. Clear? So next, 5 square plus 12 square is equal to 13 square. Is this 5, 12, 13 forms a Pythagorean triplet? 5, 12, 13 forms a Pythagorean triplet? Let's check. 5 square plus 12 square is equal to 13 square. Okay, the largest number is C. The small number is 12 and the smallest number than this is 5, that is A. So 5 square plus 12 square is equal to 13 square. 5 square is 25, right? So 5 square is 25 plus 12 square is 144, which is equal to 13 square is 169. 13 square is 169. See, 25 plus 144, how much you get? 169, which is equal to 169. Right, so LHS becomes equal to RHS. So what we can say? 5, 12, 13 forms a Pythagoras triplet. Clear? So in this way, we are getting the Pythagoras triplets like 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, 5, 12, 13 and many others. So now, we shall find some of the other Pythagorean triplets. How you can find? How you can form the other Pythagoras triplets? See, 3, 4, 5. This is a Pythagoras triplet, right? By multiplying the same numbers to all these, we can get a Pythagorean triplet. See, for example, multiplying 2. Multiply 2 to 3, 4, 5. What you will get? 3, 2 is 6, 4, 2 is 8, 5, 2 is 10. 6, 8, 10 forms a Pythagoras triplet, right? See, if you do 6 square plus 8 square is equal to 10 square, you will get a LHS is equal to RHS. So that what we can say? 6, 8 and 10 will form a Pythagorean triplet. Right. So next, if you multiply by if you multiply it by 3, okay, if you multiply 3, 4, 5, this is our standard Pythagorean triplet. We can multiply the same numbers to these three numbers to get the other Pythagorean triplets. See, multiply by 3. How much again? 3 threes are 9. 3 fours are 12. Okay. Okay. 3 fives are 15. Okay. 9, 12, 15 are the Pythagorean triplets formed by this 3, 4, 5 by multiplying by 3. Okay. So, by multiplying the same numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, you will get the many Pythagorean triplets. So, if you multiply this 3, 4, 5 by 0.1, by 0.1, what you will get? 0.1 into 3, 0.3. 0.1 into 4, 0.4. Okay, 0.1 into 5, 0.5. These also forms a Pythagorean triplet. Per plus b square is equal to c square. To check whether they form a Pythagorean triplet or not, we can substitute these values in the place of a, b, c, and we can find if LHS becomes equal to RHS, then we can say these three forms are Pythagorean triplet. So if you multiply this 3, 4, 5 by 10, what you will get? 30, 40, 50. This also forms a Pythagorean triplet. Okay. By using the standard Pythagorean triplet, that is 3, 4, 5, we can construct or we can form many other Pythagorean triplets by multiplying these numbers with the same number. Okay. So now, formula to find the Pythagorean triplets. Okay. There is a formula to find the Pythagoras triplets. So 2m whole square plus m square minus 1 whole square is equal to m square plus 1 whole square. This is a very important formula you have to remember. That is 2m whole square plus m square minus 1 whole square is equal to m square plus 1 whole square. Here, in this formula, 2m, m square minus 1, m square plus 1 are Pythagorean triplets. Okay, this is in the form of A, B, this is C. Okay, so A, B, C are the Pythagorean triplets. Okay, so 2m, m square minus 1, m square plus 1 are Pythagorean triplets. With an example, you shall understand this. Okay. So, with an example, you shall understand this. What is an example given? Write a Pythagorean triplets whose smallest number is 8. Okay. So, let's take this 2m, m square minus 1, m square minus 1, m square plus 1. These three forms of Pythagorean triplets. What they are saying? In these three Pythagorean triplet, there is a smallest number, that is 8. Okay. If a smallest number of the Pythagorean triplet is 8, then find the Pythagorean triplet. So let's take any one of this term has 8. Let's take this 2m has 8. Okay, let's take 2m has 8. This is the smallest number we shall take. Okay, let's take 2m is equal to 8. So here observe, 2m is the smallest number, right? See, m square, 2m is the smallest number. See, let's see, if m is equal to 2, then if m is equal to 2, then 2 into 2, that is 4. So m square, that is 2 square minus 1, that is 4 minus 1, 3. And m square, 2 square, that is 4 plus 1, that is 5. Okay, here I have taken 2m is equal to 8. Why I have put 2m is equal to 8? We shall check by taking m square minus 1 has 8. M square minus 1, minus 1. We shall take this number as an 8. Okay, see, these three are the Pythagorean triplets. In this, any one of the term may be a smallest. We don't know which term is 8, which is the smallest. So let's take any one of the term. Let's take m square minus 1 first. Is equal to 8. This is the smallest number in this Pythagorean triplet. Okay, m square minus 1 is a smallest number, that is 8 in this Pythagorean triplet. We shall assume. So what you will get? M square is equal to 8 plus 1. So m is equal to 8 plus 1 is 9. So m square is equal to 8 plus 1 is 9. So m is equal to square root of 9, that is 3. Here m we got 3. So if we substitute m is equal to 3 here in this Pythagorean triplet, what you will get? 2m, that is 2 into 3. 3 square plus 1? 3 square, 9 plus 1, 10. So, 6, 8, 10. Is it a Pythagorean triplet according to our question? No. It is a Pythagorean triplet. But according to our question, what they had given? Write a Pythagorean triplet whose smallest number is 8. But here in this case, the smallest number is 6. So, we cannot take m square minus 1 has 8. We shall take 2m has 8. Okay, let's check by taking 2m has 8. Now, we have taken 2m is equal to 8. So, m is equal to 8 by 2, that is equal to 4. So, m is equal to 4. Yes, now we got m is equal to 4. Now, we shall substitute in this formula. 2m is equal to 2 into 4, that is 8. So, 2m is equal to 2 into 4, which is equal to 8. Now, next one, m square minus 1. That is, m square is 4 square minus 1. 4 square means 16 minus 1, that is 15. Right? So, again, one more number, that is m square plus 1 by using the third formula. So, 4 square plus 1. 4 4 is 16 plus 1, that is 17. So, now what you got the Pythagorean triplets? 8, 15, 17. This forms a Pythagorean triplet. Is this a Pythagorean triplet according to our question? Yes. So, in the question they had given, find the Pythagorean triplets in which the smallest number is 8. In this Pythagorean triplet, the smallest number is 8, the next is 15 and next is 17. Yes. This is a perfect Pythagorean triplet according to our question. Right. So, 6, 8, 10 is also a Pythagorean triplet. But according to our question, they had asked the smallest number is 8. But here the smallest number is 6. So, we cannot take this triplet. We can take this triplet. 8, 15, 17 has a Pythagorean triplet according to our question in which the smallest number is 8. Clear? So, by taking this, any one of the formula as a given number, we can easily find the other triplets. Okay? Other numbers of the triplets. Clear? So, this is about the first example to find the Pythagorean triplet. Then, what is the second example they have given? Find the Pythagorean triplet in which one member is 12. So, find the Pythagorean triplet in which one member is 12. So, they are saying one of the member in this Pythagorean triplet is 12. So, let's take any one of the term as 12. That is, m square minus 1 I will take as 12. Let's assume. So, m square minus 1. This term has 12 I will assume. Because they are given in a question, in this Pythagorean, find the Pythagorean triplets in which one of the term is, any one of the term is 12. So, I will take m square minus 1 as 12. So, m is equal to 12 plus 1, right? Minus 1 goes to the right, it becomes plus 1. That is, m square is equal to 12 plus 1. So, m square is equal to 30. So, we cannot get a square, the square root of 30. So, this is not a perfect one. So, we cannot take m square minus 1 has 12. Okay. So, this is not right. So, let's take 2m has 12. Okay. Let's take 2m has 12. If you do m is equal to, what you will get? Square root of 13. The square root of 13 is not an integer. Hence, we cannot take m square minus 1 has 12. So, let. Now, we shall take 2m has 12. 2m has 12. So, let's assume 2m has 12.
Yes, because the number, the question they had given,
find the Pythagorean triplet in which one of the member is 12. So here we got one of the number 12 and 35, 37. So this is a Pythagorean triplet. So to check this is a Pythagorean triplet is not, what we can do? We can substitute these values in the place of this formula in the equation 1. That is 2m whole square plus m square minus 1 whole square, which is equal to m square plus 1. 2m whole square means 12 whole square plus 35 whole square, which is equal to 37 whole square. Okay. So when you do 12 square plus 35 square, which is equal to 37 square, if you get LHS is equal to RHS, then you can say this is our perfect Pythagorean triplet. Okay. So in this way, by using this formula, we can easily find the Pythagorean triplets. Okay. So this is about the today's class. In the next class, we shall solve the exercise 5.2. Thank you.